हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज समीरन मैथी, सीनियर लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक। आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर चैप्टर नंबर 3। द टाइटल फॉर द सेम इज एरर डिटेक्शन, करेक्शन एंड वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन। सो वंस द चैप्टर गेट्स ओवर, द लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज IEEE विद देयर स्टैंडर्ड्स, वॉट इज ब्लूटूथ आर्किटेक्चर, द टाइप्स ऑफ नेटवर्क यूज्ड इन ब्लूटूथ आर्किटेक्चर, डिफरेंस बिटवीन पीकोनेट एंड स्कैटरनेट, and the most important among them is difference between different generations. So firstly, IEEE stands for Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers. They were chosen to develop standards to enable all devices and systems to communicate together. So basically, they were given responsibility for designing standards that could deal in efficient communication among two or more devices. So these are some IEEE standards, ranging from 802.1 to 802.5, and as far as wireless LAN technology is concerned, the IEEE standard for the same is 802.11. It is not 8802, it is just 802.11. Regarding summary of 802.11 standards, these are various standards designed by IEEE. So starting with 802.11, its frequency is 2.4 gigahertz. Regarding 11A, it is 5 gigahertz. 11B, it is 2.4 gigahertz. Same for G and N, right? Regarding speed, as you can see, the speed goes on increasing. We could say that the speed for 802.11 is 1 to 2 Mbps. For 11A, it is till 54 Mbps. Regarding 11B, it is up to 11 Mbps. Regarding 11G, it is up to 54 Mbps. And 11N is the fastest among them. Its speed can go till 600 Mbps. Regarding topology, that is the designing of 802.11, it is an ad hoc in design, ad hoc in the sense, the summary, or I could say in a shorter word, ad hoc means wireless technology. Regarding range, as you could see, the range is increasing from 11 to 11N. The range for 11 is 20 feet. Regarding 11A, it is 25 to 75 feet. Regarding 11B, it is 150 feet. 11G, same. 11N, it goes on till 175, right? And regarding access methods, it all uses CourierSense multiple agency, right? So this is a factual data, you have to remember this. And they could ask questions like difference between 802.11 and 802.11A or 802.11B and 802.11N. So all this comparison type of questions could be dealt with this sort of factual data. You have to remember all this data. Regarding Bluetooth, I hope everyone is familiar with Bluetooth. It is a short range wireless technology that let us connect computers, mobile phones, etc. It eliminates the need for the cables that connect devices together, right? So it is a wireless technology, and it defines two types of networks, namely Piconet and Scatternet. So let us see what is Piconet and Scatternet. For example, if there are five devices connected to each other via Bluetooth, so one of them will be working as a primary or master device, and the other devices would be considered as a slave device or a secondary device. Fine. So one of them will be a primary device, which will guide all other devices how to work or how to communicate, and all other devices apart from primary would work as secondary devices or slave devices. This is a Piconet architecture. Regarding Scatternet, as you can see, Scatternet is a combination of two or more Piconets. So we have Piconet 1, in which we have one primary device and four secondary devices. Regarding Piconet 2, the one which is at the right hand side, we have two secondary devices and one primary devices. But that particular bridge slave, will work as a secondary device in Piconet 1, that is the left hand side. But for Piconet, that is the one at the right hand side, that for considering that Piconet, in that particular Piconet, the one device which was secondary in PicoNet 1 will work as a primary in PicoNet 2. So that particular device which works depending on the PicoNet as primary or secondary is known as bridge slave. So scatternet is nothing but a combination of two or more PicoNets, and accordingly bridge slave could work depending on the PicoNet it is working for, right? So difference between PicoNet and scatternet. So in PicoNet it is a network of 8 stations, and maximum 8 stations or 8 devices could be connected with the help of a PicoNet. Regarding scatternet, many PicoNets can be combined to form a scatternet. A station is a member of only one network. So here only one network is there, only one PicoNet is there, but it could, a scatternet consists of one or more PicoNets. In the sense, a station can be a member of one or more than one PicoNet, as the one we have seen. The bridge slave was a member of PicoNet 1 as well as PicoNet 2. PicoNet can have up to 8 stations. One station is primary station. A secondary station in one PicoNet can be a primary in another PicoNet, which we have seen in the bridge slave. In this Bluetooth network, device can function either as master or slave. But in scatternet, device can function as master or slave or master plus slave. Right? So it could be master plus slave as well. And PicoNet serves small coverage area. It covers large coverage area because there are combination of PicoNets. It supports maximum 8 nodes, but scatternet can support more than 8 nodes. So this was it regarding chapter number 3, part 1. Remember students, for chapter number 3 there will be 2 videos. I'll soon upload the second video. Till then, take care, bye.